Hello, geometry class. For today's classwork, we're going to go all the way back to Algebra 1 to cover and review this topic, namely factoring. Oops. Just to quickly summarize this concept, factoring is to go from a quadratic expression, namely an expression with a quadratic term, and to turn it into two factors. Both of which are binomials. So, before we begin, I must note that the method two-factor is different depending on which school you came from and which country you came from, because there are many ways to factor out a quadratic expression. Today, we're going to cover a method called the crisscross method. Now, don't worry if you don't know how to do the crisscross method, because one, we're going to cover that today, and two, you don't have to use the crisscross method. You can use the method that you're more familiar with and still get the same answer. Now, before I cover the crisscross method, however, I'm going to be covering the patterns that helped us get the crisscross method. The reason why I'm going to cover the patterns first is so that you understand the thought behind the method, so that even if you don't use a crisscross method, you're able to understand why the method you learned works. Because all the methods out there for factoring quadratic expressions pretty much come from recognizing the patterns that I'm going to outline for you today. All right, so without further ado, let's get to it. So we're going to be looking at a couple of FOIL patterns. So what do I mean by FOIL patterns? Well, if you have a binomial multiplied by a binomial, what do? Well, you multiply out this term with this term, which happens to be the first term with the first term, namely f. Then you're going to multiply this term with this term, namely the outside terms, hence the letter O. Then this term with this one, which are the inside terms, hence the letter I. And then this term with this term, which are the last terms, hence the mnemonic FOIL, to help you remember that you have to multiply four times in order to get the expression. Now, if we did that, we would have gotten x squared for having done the first term, then the outside term, which would have given us 9x, then the inside terms, which would have given us 1x, and the last terms, which would have given us 9. 9x plus 1x, however, will give you 10x. And so, yes, using FOIL, we're able to do out all of the examples that I've outlined here. But the reason why I've done them out already is because FOIL is not what we're studying here. We're instead studying how to go backwards from right to left. To go from left to right, of course we will use FOIL, and the lesson doesn't go on further than that. But to go from right to left, we have to recognize some patterns, or else we're going to be stuck in a trial and error repetition, if you will, because you have to try out and see if your guesses work or not, and then try again if your guesses don't work. And the more complicated the question gets, the more times you have to do the trial and error. So it takes a long time. All right, so I've done quite a lot of talking, so let's get down to business. Stop the video now to see if you can recognize any patterns from the examples given. Alright, so you might have already recognized this pattern, but I can, just by looking at the third term or the constant term, quickly recognize its relationship with these two numbers. Do you see the pattern? Good. Right. Namely, you're going to multiply them. So for example, if you multiplied positive 1 to positive 4, you will get positive 4. If I multiplied positive 1 with positive 8, I will indeed get positive 8. Likewise, if I multiply positive 2 with positive 5, I will indeed get positive 10. And you could do this for all the examples that I've outlined here, and it will stay true. So great, we have one pattern down. What is the second pattern? Well, the second pattern relates to this term. the middle term, or the linear term, as it's called. Do you see the relationship between the linear term and the numbers that we've just identified? Good. We can see that all we have to do to these two numbers, instead of multiplying this time, we are adding. So let's take some examples. 1, positive 1, plus positive 6 will in fact give you positive 7. Positive 2 plus positive 2 will in fact give you positive 4. Positive 2 plus positive 7 will in fact give you positive 9. And this will again be true for all of the other examples given out. So, to summarize, we can see that the relationship between the last term and the two numbers is going to be that of a multiplication. Whereas for the middle term, that pattern is going to be of addition. So again, multiplication to go from the third term to the numbers that we want, and addition to go from the middle term to the numbers that we want. So let's do out an example to see if we've actually understood this. So if you look at this example, x squared plus 10x plus 24, I want to rewrite this in this format, hence factor. So what do I have to do? Well, I'm going to first look at this number, positive 24, and look at all the numbers that multiply into positive 24, namely pairs of numbers that multiply to 24. So 1 times 24, 2 times 12, 3 times 4, 4 times 6, 5 times, nope, 5 doesn't work, 6 times, 6 times 4, and now I've already repeated the patterns, so I don't need to write 6 times 4, and I know that all the other pairs that I've not written out are pretty much the same pairs that I've written out already. So next, I'm going to be looking at the middle term, namely 10. And what's the relationship between the numbers that we have identified with this number 10? They have to add to it. So 1 plus 24 is not 10, and neither is 2 plus 12 or 3 plus 4. But 4 plus 6 is 10. So we know that our answer will be x plus 4 times x plus 6. Let's check our answer to see if we've done it correctly. If I have x plus 4 times x plus 6, and I do out FOIL, first with first, last with last, inside with inside, and last with last. I said last with last before, but that was for outside. If we combine the like terms, what do you know? We get the expression that we started out with, so we know we factored it out correctly. All right, let's look at some other patterns.